Hi friends, in this video I will explain overall three different topologies in Network Simulator 3. And basically the first one is fuzz.cc. here all the topologies. Next we are going to see how these topologies we can program by using C++. Now coming to the first topology in NS3, the program default programs are there, that is named as fuzz.cc for this topology. Actually this topology is about point to point connection between two nodes N0 and N1 by using this IP address 10.1.1.0. in this N1 is treated as client, N0 is treated as server. Now how this topology works means here at 2 nanosecond client sent 1024 byte, this is the packet size, to this IP address and the port number is 9. First client send the data, client send the data to the server. Next in 2.00369 second server received that packet of size 1024 bytes from this IP address and this is the port number. Again at the same time server sent 1024 bytes to this port, this IP address and to this port. Again at 2.00737 second client received this data. Here overall these two nodes are exchanging a packet of 1024 size, that is 1024 byte size. Now it is the topology 1 in NS3. This is named as fuzz.cc. Now second one is second.cc. Second.cc, before starting the second.cc, now we'll see how to execute, how to run this fuzz.cc and what is the program behind this fuzz.cc and this topology in NS3. We'll see that one. 1 minute. Now here it is the malady. Now let me start from the beginning here. First open the terminal. Here in the search box you simply type the terminal. Okay, it will give the terminal window. Here that is the folder, NS3 folder. Now that is in the desktop, that's why first you go to the desktops, change the directory, cd desktop, desktop. Ls list of files, again cd change directory, ns all in one 3.29. now in that subdirectory, that is ns 3.29, here cd change directory ns 3.29. now here ls, these are the files in ns 3.29. now there are two important folders, one is example, second one is the scratch. In NS3, one advantage is predefined programs are available in this example folder. Directly we can use these programs. But my suggestion is copy those files to the scratch, then you run those files. Okay, to avoid some practical issues, you do that one. First you copy those required files into scratch and after that you execute those files. Now in examples tutorial, here overall three files are there, first, second and third. I will explain you what is the topologies behind these. Simply copy these three files and come to the examples and outside scratch, you simply paste these files in scratch folder. After that we'll run. Okay, let me start with the fuzz.cc. second, third. Okay, three files are there. Let me start with the first.cc. Before that, once we'll see what is the program inside this file. Okay, first.cc. Already I'm explained the topology. Now once see this topology, there are two nodes. These two nodes are going to exchange the information, that is packet size is 1024 bytes. Here before going to the program, once see this, already in the last video I'm explained this, whenever you're programming in NS3, here first we need to know the topology, header files, namespace, main, variable declaration, that is number of nodes we need to define, and after that here channel, net device, protocol stack, and on the top of the protocol stack we need to define the application. Now here in meanwhile there are intermediately we require few topology helpers. Now keep these in your mind while I'm explaining the program. Now I'll see the program part. Now here first one we'll start with the header files, and after that namespace, main, that is generally C++ will start with the main, and command lines here some logs we are going to define to save the activities what we are going to do, and after that node container, that is node container here. Overall there are two nodes, N0 and N1. Here node container nodes, that is we are going to create the two nodes, and after that here I told you that topology helpers. In each and every level we require few helpers, and here in the node level, node device level, everywhere we are going to use these helpers. Okay, here point to point helper, point to point, that is helper name, and after that point to point here we are going to define the data rate as well as delay. Okay, here if you observe this, first node we are defined, and after that net devices. Here actually node means that is simply a computer, and to that node we generally for internet we are going to connect modem, that is the net device. Here after creating the node we need to define the net device. Here in programming also we are doing the same. Here these are the net device containers. Here the number of nodes are 2, that's why net device container is for the 2 nodes we are going to install these devices. After that here the internet stack, helper stack, I told you that here node device are completed. Next one is the stack we need to define, that is going to describe the protocols. Here it is the point to point, here internet stack helper, net devices, and after that internet stack helper. Next we need to define the application, sorry, IP address, and here is the application part. On the top here there is one application. Here both the nodes we need to define the application. In this application we are going to define what are the activities, what activity the nodes need to do. Okay, here I'm already explained in the topology both the nodes are going to exchange the 1024 bytes. The communication will start at 2 seconds. Here the same thing we are going to describe in the application. Here that is application container. Overall there are 3 containers here: node container, net device container, and the application container. here, get one, node one is the server, node zero is the client. Okay, initially the communication will start at 2 seconds. These are going to exchange the packets of size 1024 bytes. Yeah, this is the application what we are going to write. This is the basic programming in NS3. Now we'll see how to run this one. Sorry for this. .wav space hyphen hyphen run space. Actually, we copied these two files in Scratch. That's why Scratch forward slash first. Here for C++, there is no need of extension. Simply you enter it. Now my suggestion is don't keep too many files in Scratch. Okay, every time it is going to read the all the files, means it will take time. That's why my suggestion only you keep present executing file in Scratch. But here unfortunately I placed too many files in the Scratch folder, that's why it is taking little time. See these many files, so many files. It is going to compiling all the files unnecessarily. Now here the program is executed. Here already we are seeing at 2 seconds client send 1024 bytes to this IP address, and this is the port number. Port number is 9. And here you will find, okay, next again at 2.0 I'm already explained what the topology we are expecting. Same we are going to get the result here. Next we'll see how to run the netanim. Okay, for netanim we need to include the one additional library, that is include a hyphen, that is double inverted commas, ns3 net netanim hyphen module .h. This is the required header file to run the netanim. At the bottom, before simulation stop, okay, here you include one command, animation animation interface space anim, within the brackets here you give the file name. Here I am giving first.xml. Here this file, next we are going to use to create the graph, to create the animation. We are going to use this file, and after that I would like to define the node's position. Actually, if there is any mobility in the nodes, then you can define the position. But unfortunately here there is no mobility for the two nodes, but I will show you how to set constant position to the node. But in reality it's not required, only the first command, animation interface space anim first.xml. by default it is going to create the XML file. Simply copy paste here this one, nodes space dot get one. Here I'm changing the coordinates for that node, 1020. Okay, save this one. Now again we'll run this one, this file first.cc, again .wav run scratch first. Here mobility, there are no mobility nodes. It is showing the same warning. No need to consider. Now here you will find one file, that is first.xml. see, this is the first.xml. now this file we are going to use in NetAnim, that is network animation. That's here you once come to the NS all-in-one directory. In that NetAnim, you simply enter into that NetAnim by using chain directly, that is directory, copy, paste. Oh, it's good. And after that .// capital N, net A N, capital A N, NetAnim. Now here it will give you the some new window, and the file is in NS 3.29. here first.xm. oh, see, two nodes, N0, N1. One is server, second one is the client. We can change the number of lines as well as node size also. We can change, simply you run here, the topology is working. Okay, thank you friends. I hope this video will help you to get an idea on different topologies and how to do the programming and how to create the NetAnim and how to see this exchange of packets animated version by using NetAnim. Now here similarly, you can find that second.cc here. Sorry for this. Second.cc, it is also available in NS3. You run this one, but here it is additional to the point to point. There is one LAN connection, that is CSMA. And coming to the third.cc, now this topology is, it is taking three Wi-Fi nodes. One is the access point node and four are the LAN nodes, that is CSMA nodes. It is also logical topology, help us to design IoT type of networks. I'll show you one example of IoT. And this is an example of IoT, IoT topology, Wi-Fi, access point and server. These are connected by using internet. This is an example IoT topology. Here these all are the sensor nodes. Thank you friends for watching this video. Okay. For more information, you can visit my website www.tln.co.in. Thank you.